Poetics is the only way that you should be gearing from 1 to 89. I'm going to go over everything Poetic as well as anything else you need to be doing with extra gear that you won't be using. This is true for your main job or if you're leveling alt jobs. So let's start with levels 1 through 49. At this point, you will just be equipping everything that drops. So when you do dungeon runs or when a quest gives you gear, just equip it right away. The poetics won't start until level 50. So just make sure to keep equipping everything that you obtain to make sure your item level stays near what dungeon you're at. This is important for now and the future, since your item level being under dungeon requirements can heavily work against you on taking damage or healing less. So always make sure to equip your highest item levels that you have in your inventory from 1 to 49. Once you hit level 50, you would have just gotten your job gear if you're doing this the first time around. Even though you do have your job gear, that is mostly for glamour at this point. You can now switch to using your poetics. The poetics currency is currency that you get from doing dungeons, trials, amongst other things in the game. This is our base currency, and you will always have an abundance of poetics. Luckily, there are a lot of things to spend it on gear-wise, especially if you're wanting to level other jobs. The reason we use poetics for gear instead of dungeon gear or gear that you get from the main story is simply because it's the highest item level for that expansion. The first example I'm going to give you is for your level 50 poetics. If you see here, level 50 poetics has an item level of 130. If you're at the vendor, you can see that there are other level 50 poetics as well, but their item level is lower, 110. Why is this important? Well, if we go to the last dungeon of that expansion, we will see that the last dungeon is item level required of 120. So if you purchase the poetics, you would still be 10 item levels above the last dungeon. This is precisely why we use poetics gear when we get to the new expansion. I personally believe they worked it out this way, so you only have to use poetics and you can get gear easily for all 20 of your jobs. As well as similar roles share poetic gear, so you only have to get 4 or 5 sets of poetic gear. I had done a video about this before, but I wanted to be more specific and more detailed in this video, as well as update it for Endwalker. You can get this level 50 poetics gear from 2 places, but be aware it is not available until you hit a certain main quest story, so you can't jump ahead. I do believe with the first level 50 poetics, I really searched for it and I can't seem to find it anywhere, but once you hit level 50, you should be able to purchase your level 50 item level 130 gear. Make sure do not purchase the item level 110. The 130 is the one that's going to take you to the end of that expansion. You can purchase these from Orianna in Mordona, or once unlocked, you can purchase these from the vendors in the 3 main cities, which I will show here. I tested this and you cannot get later level poetic gear, say level 60 or level 70, from the vendors in the 3 cities. You have to go to that corresponding expansion. Once you get this gear, then the next one you want to get once you leveled up and get far enough in the story is level 60, item level 270 poetics gear. Be wary again that you are able to purchase level 60, item level 240, and you do not want that one. You want to make sure to purchase the 270. You can get this gear from Idleshire in the main story once you hit there and unlock a certain main quest story, or you can purchase this from the Splendor Rowena vendors in Ishgard. They will not be there until you're able to purchase them, so don't worry about missing them. You will need to complete the main story quest, A Great New Nation, and that will allow you to purchase the level 60, item level 270 poetics gear. Oh, I did forget to mention, if you want to purchase the weapons, then you would just go to the vendor to the right on any of these and look for that specific poetics gear exchange. So for Mordona, you're looking for Ironworks exchange, and for Ishgard, you are looking for Shire gear exchange. These will allow you to purchase the weapons. as the gear and accessories and weapons are two separate vendors. If we look at the last dungeon, then you can see that requires item level 260 gear. So again, you will be able to complete the entire expansion with just this poetic set. Near the end of the video, I will talk about what to do with other pieces of gear, so stay tuned for that. We will then move on to the Stormblood expansion. This is the one place that there's a little bit of a catch, but I will cover that here for you. Once you get to Stormblood and you finish the main quest called Stormblood, then you can purchase the level 70 item level 400 Poetics gear. The only problem here is that the Stormblood main story quest is required an item level 280 gear, and we only have 270. But fear not, doing the main story, they will give you the gear needed in order to do this quest. So this is really the only time that you have to upgrade your gear, but the game will give it to you automatically, so you don't have to worry about it. After this, our level 70 item level 400 Poetics gear will get us to the end of Shadowbringers. You can purchase this from a vendor in Rogar's Reach, or you can purchase this from, again, a vendor Splendor, that's what my nickname is for them, in Kugane. Once you complete the main story Shadowbringers, then you'll be able to purchase the level 80 item level 530, which is going to take you all the way through the new Endwalker expansion. As we see, the last quest, level 89, is item level 520 required. You can get this Poetics gear located in Yulmore from this vendor, as well as the vendor Splendor that's located in the Crystarium near the main Aetherite. Believe it or not, even with this evidence, I have many players who are constantly telling me that it's better to do this gear or that gear, but the facts are the facts, and that is you are able to get through the entire main story with Poetics gear, with the exception of that one little Stormblood quest. Now let's talk about what you're going to do with the copious amounts of other gear that you get through the main story or through the dungeons, because they do have very important uses. The number one thing you can do with the main story gear is to actually just sell it. Many players are not going to see this video, and out of the millions and millions of players of Final Fantasy XIV, they don't know to use Poetics gear, or they're looking for certain gear for glamour pieces. So you can still make a good amount of money by selling things between 8,000, 20,000, 50,000. Some of it even goes for 80,000. So you want to make sure to always check your retainer and check how much the gear goes for. What you can do with your dungeon gear is, if it's high quality or tradable, then you can sell it on the market board as well, because a lot of people look for certain dungeon glamours. Or more importantly, you can turn it in for expert deliveries and get Grand Company seals. There are tons of things that you need Grand Company seals for, and dungeon gear into expert deliveries will give you literally never-ending Grand Company seals. You do have to unlock that, which I do have a video on, and I will leave it at the end of this video. I am really passionate about making sure that everyone has all the information, since Final Fantasy XIV is such a big game, and this is one of those pieces of information that a lot of people miss out on. So I really hope that this video clarifies that Poetics gear is the best gear to use while you're leveling up any job from 1 to 89. So make sure to tell your friends in game that they should be using Poetics gear, as it's just the easiest to obtain. I really hope that this video helped you or someone you may know, and don't forget to limit break 3 that subscribe button down below to get notified of all my new Endwalker videos. I want to give a huge shout out to my Patreon supporters, as if it wasn't for you guys, I wouldn't be able to make videos on this channel as consistently as I do. If you want to watch more Final Fantasy Endwalker tutorials, then you can click here.